to lose any weight.
You're kidding, right? You look great. Very thin.
You can always be thinner. Look better. Did you know that Ted Bundy's first dog, a collie, was named Lassie? Did you hear this?
Who's Ted Bundy?
I forgot.
Job anyway. See why you just don't quit.
Because I want to fit in.
And though I can hide my cold gaze, and you can shake my hand and feel flesh gripping yours, and maybe you can even sense our lifestyles are probably comfortable, I simply am not there. Let's see Paul Mallon.
Goes out with that loser, Patrick Babin. What a dork. Another martini, Paul.
Babin is such a dork. Such a boring, spineless, lightweight.
Anything wrong, Patrick? You're sweating. What about dinner? Is that all you ever have to contribute that way? What about fucking dinner?
Cheer up there, Babin. What's the matter? No shiatsu this morning?
Don't you mean that? All that stuff.
Hold on there, little buddy.
No smoking, not either. No, put it in the cart.
Stop. My name is Patrick Babin. I'm 27 years old. I believe in taking care of myself.
You can always be thinner, look better.
In a balanced diet and a rigorous exercise routine.
Ask me a question.
So what do you do?
Don't you want to know what I do?
No. No, not really. You have a really nice place here, Paul. How much did you pay for it?
Well, actually, that's none of your business, Christy. But I can assure you, it certainly wasn't cheap.
If you don't shut your fucking mouth, I will kill you.
I like to dissect girls. Did you know I'm utterly insane?
Murders and executions, mostly.
I need to engage in homicidal behavior on a massive scale.
I couldn't tell you that, Halberstram, but then I'd have to kill you. I killed another girl with a chainsaw. I had to. She almost got away. Someone else there, I can't remember, maybe a model, but he's dead too. And Paul Allen. I killed Paul Allen with an axe in the face. His body is dissolving in a bathtub in Hell's Kitchen.
There are no more barriers to cross. All I have in common with the uncontrollable and the insane, the vicious and the evil, all the mayhem I have caused and my utter indifference toward it, I have now surpassed. My pain is constant and sharp, and I do not hope for a better world for anyone. In fact, I want my pain to be inflicted on others. I want no one to escape. But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me. And I gain no deeper knowledge of myself. No new knowledge can be extracted from my telling. His confession has meant nothing.